Wow, what's up everybody? Once again, it's Brand Man Sean, and I got a message, man. Artists, get a job. Nah, but seriously, not even just get a job. Don't feel bad if you have a job, because I know it can be hard out here these days. So many people make it seem like, yo, just get out there. You need to quit your job. Go head on. Burn all your bridges. That's the only way to be successful. Yeah. But let's really break this down. To be successful in music, you need to make songs. You need to market yourself. These things right here cost money. So we're going to talk a little bit about some context for this, but then on top of that, I think there's some general recommendations that could be pretty useful for artists. And not just artists, anybody who's trying to build their own thing. Number one, when we look at music, we look at people like Jay-Z and Biggie Smalls, right? People like them, they obviously never had the traditional job that they had to quit. However, they were still making money, and we know what they were making money from. They were still working a job of sorts, whether it was traditional or non-traditional. And I've heard stories with both of them how they were not really willing to just jump into music. They had to make sure that they were going to be able to replace this income to basically make up for the lifestyle that they were used to living, because they were making a good money at doing what they were doing. And I think that speaks on a reality that a lot of artists might miss. When we talk about a lot of these people that are blowing up, these people have more money than you think, whether they're getting it from the street somewhere, or if they have some investors because their family has money, or they just got connected in the right way for some money, is coming from somewhere. You might not have that scenario. You might just have to work and save, work and save, work and save. And a lot of times you're better off working and saving versus I'm gonna save a little bit and now I got $100 this month and I'm gonna spend $100 this month. Sometimes it's better just to save until you have a big, big budget. But that's an entirely different conversation. What I think is super beneficial, because I know a lot of artists are like, yo man, when I work, it takes away from my creativity because a job is just too taxing. And also, I don't know when I'm gonna be able to have time for a studio and things like that. Well, I think we're in a beneficial age where, because of technology, there's all these jobs that are popping up that allow you to take these tasks, and they're not necessarily a job where you're working under a manager who's annoying and it's killing your creativity and all that good stuff. I'm talking about stuff like Ubers and the Lyfts. Those don't make necessarily the money that they used to, but there's a lot of other apps and side jobs like that that you can look up and find. For instance, there was this app called Instacart. A homegirl of a homegirl told me that she made $500 in one day trying Instacart. And I'm like, I'm not above $500. If I'll try that out myself when I got extra time. So I tried it out. I didn't make $500 in a day, but $25 an hour was what I made that day. That's not really that bad if it's something that you just are doing in your own extra time, especially, you know, for me, it's not like it's my job or anything. I said, hey, it's Sunday, I'm not doing anything, let me try this out. But at the end of the day, that's more money than a lot of these jobs that are making $12 an hour, $9 an hour. So if you have like a car, or you have just the ability to try out some of these other weird jobs that they have out here, or these weird apps that allow you to do things, I suggest y'all look deeper into that. If somebody knows apps like that allow you to make good money, I suggest you put it in the comment section below so you can help other people out, because these things allow you to do it pretty much on your own time, and that's gonna allow you to be flexible as an artist. Like, we already know Uber and Lyft, that's whenever you want to. Again, just depending on where you live, I guess, as far as the money goes, but I know for a fact they don't make as good money as they used to, but they could be helpful depending on where you live. But there's plenty of apps that are definitely worth trying. And you might land on gold if you find one early on and commit to it, because what I found is when a lot of these apps are newer, or when a lot of these programs are newer, what they're essentially trying to do is incentivize people to get on their platform and start helping deliver. So those people are going to make more money. Like, you'll see it time and time again with these apps. The people who start using it first, they're gonna be like, yo man, I'm making good checks, I'm making a lot of money. And then they're gonna tell other people word of mouth, and as they bring other people on, on, there's going to be a lot more Uber drivers or a lot more Lyft drivers, for example. And then as there's more Lyft drivers, now Uber's like, yo, you know what? Now we have enough drivers. We don't have to give them as much money. We don't have to have as high of a referral bonus. And the money goes down from there. It still may be decent for you, but it's still going to not be as high as before. So if you can find something new or you see something new come to your area, it might be worth trying out, because in the meantime, you can flip some good money, make that money, and push it towards what you need to. But I just wanted to do this video. I think it's really important that artists again and again realize, with this independent mindset especially, you are investing in yourself. So you have to figure out where you're going to get the money to invest in yourself from. All this mess about this instant success or like not working a job or I'm hustling this way or that way, that's cool, but it's nothing wrong with having a job. I know people who have 9-to-5s and they're artists. And some of them are probably further along than you would think to still be working a job, but maybe, you know, they just need more money to be comfortable quitting. Either way it goes, everybody has their own numbers they work with, but at the end of the day, everybody has to get money from somewhere to fund whatever their dream is. So I just wanted to put that thought out there, something for you all to think about. I would love to know, once again, what are some good apps and things like that to work for, especially in your area, provide any details. Maybe somebody will find that and then they'll be able to use it for themselves. And then just the overall idea of, I'm my own boss now, I don't need to work for anybody, or just feeling bad about having a 9-to-5, but calling yourself an artist. Let me hear the thoughts, the stresses that you go through thinking about that, trying to get up out that situation. Other than that though, if you like this video, go ahead and hit the like button if you like it. Might as well share it. And if you're not subscribed, you know what to do. Hit that subscribe button.